Well, that's the thing, is like, it was bad back then, but it was bad, like, because it kind of had to be, because there was, you know, only so much you could do. Whereas, like, nowadays, you have no excuse. It's just bad. Come on, now. The astral fields. I forgot about this.
After all these centuries, the usurpers of the dead show their faces.
But like, yeah, you know, if you're gonna make like some old dungeon crawler, some game that's like an old dungeon crawler, and you're like expecting to run it on like, you know, an Apple II or whatever, sure. Like, I'm not gonna expect tooltips. But if you're gonna release something and like I'm expected to play it, I would like at least basic user interface stuff. Like, give me item tooltips. If you don't want to do a minimap, sure, fine, whatever. Like, it's a pain in the ass, but okay. Yeah, there's some stuff that is just like, you're just not progressing because that's the way it's always been, and that's just kind of a poor excuse. More lore! Ooh. Heater shield, that is technically better than ours, at least on the like blocking field, but ours gives us blitz and blindside, which we desperately need. Eldritch gargoyles, huh? That's a thing. The other thing I love about Force Wave is that it stuns the shit out of everything. Oh, we've got... What's making us vulnerable? Impaired aim. 20% chance to miss. Wonderful.
Skills
just fucking wonderful. Recall correctly, this boss fight has like three phases, maybe more. I remember this boss fight being a pain in the ass. To their credit, the expansion bosses in this game are all really good. Like Malamuth's final boss is pretty good too. Fumble bullshit. Get out of here. You're impeding my ability to do violence and I don't like it. God, I love just chain stunning things with Force Wave. It feels so good. Oh, I heard something drop. Probably just junk. Okay. Send to the Eldritch Throne. Okay. Sounds like progress to me. Go ahead and... Oh, I can't put a portal down. That's... That's unfortunate. Okay. I mean, I guess we're as ready as we're gonna be. Corvax Trove, yeah, there he is. What's up, bro? Just hanging around. Okay, don't do anything on my account. I'm just here to steal your snack foods. Got any jerk? Oh no. I didn't sign up for this. Stop moving. 180,000. Yeah, that's... Ooh, that's some bullshit. Maybe 180,000 in this phase. No. Nope. We actually got through this expansion quicker than I figured we would. Well... For what, maybe 10 hours, I think? No, I guess that's about right. I was figuring it at about 12 hours. Malmuth is... I would say probably... Yeah, about that length, maybe a little shorter. Getting to Malmuth is going to be a process, but... That is not a problem for present-day Gene, so I'm not going to worry over much about it. There's no way I can just sit here and trade blows with this dude. I bet you I don't want to stand in that. Dude, are you like... No, you're just giving me a dot. I was gonna say, is he causing me to fumble too? I was about to be a salty, salty bitch. Man, I really like the boss fights in this game a lot. I checked out Path of Exile again for this, their newest league. I didn't actually play the league, I just puttered around on Standard, and I was reminded why I stopped playing Path of Exile. The boss fights in that game are so fucking bad. Phase one done. He broke his hand guards. Caster phase? No. He's just... He's got twice the arms. Dude, you and me both. Celestial Effigy. Alright, what's this doing? Celestial Effigy empowers Korvac and harms mortals. Okay. These things need to die.
Can't do that.
They buff his ass. That needs to be a no. Oh, and he has adds. Okay. Alright, sure. Oh, he has portals! Eldritch Rift. That's kinda cool. I'm worried. I'm very, very worried. I'm worried mostly that we don't have enough AoE to deal with this bullshit. I don't know, maybe we'll be okay. Yeah, I mean, depending on what you want to do in Path of Exile, you can kind of half-ass that aspect of it. Like, if all you're interested in is playing through the campaign, you don't really have to worry about that. You can just, like, you probably realistically, since there's no penalty for, like, really dying in the campaign, you can just kind of putter along, make your own build, and have a good time of things. It's once you get to, like, actual end game that it just becomes absolutely miserable to play. And God help you with any of the fucking RNG fest boss fights.
I can't do that yet.
But yeah, the game is chunky as fuck. One of the things that I like about this new league is that they like basically let you pick now what content you want to engage with, which I think is really good because it kind of helps with the whole, like, there's so much content thing. They give you like a passive tree, and it's like, if you want to do this content, you just put passives into these parts of the tree and you get to do that content, and you just pick and choose. And I think that's a lot better. The problem though is that, like, if you want to do any like legitimate endgame content, it's not fun. Like, you either have a ridiculous grind or you have to trade, which sucks. And then, like, once you actually try to do the content, you're gonna be like looking at boss fights that are tuned around like the mega players, like streamers and stuff, that have mechanics that'll just like instantly kill you, and you'll be like, what the fuck just killed me? And you only have 6 chances to do each boss fight, and if you run out of those, you've got to either do the grind again or do trading again. And it's just miserable. It's horrible. And the worst part is, like, most of the bosses don't drop anything worth anything. It's just like, it hurts me. Yeah, it's not. Like, Path of Exile is, like, the game has, like, it's okay if you want to just play something where you can shut your brain off and, like, zoom around and, like, insta-gib everything on a screen and, like, that's it. But if you want to actually, like, engage with endgame stuff, you're going to have a bad time unless you're, like, following a build guide or you're spending, you know, hundreds upon hundreds of hours doing basically like homework, figuring out how stuff works. Yeah, it's a grind. Which, I mean, like, I get it. It's a free-to-play action RPG, but like, holy damn. Yeah, you insta-give everything until you just randomly die and you're like, what the hell killed me, and the game doesn't tell you. And like, I had forgotten how zoomed in the game was. And like, we've been playing Grim Dawn, and like, we see how zoomed out the gameplay is here. And like, Path of Exile would be like playing Grim Dawn like this all the time. It's so zoomed in. Like, you can't see anything. It's just like, oh no. I mean, admittedly, the game, like, it looks nice. It's a nice looking game, but like, Jesus. So, yeah, I played it for, like, I don't know, 15 or 20 hours, and was like, okay, that's that. Extension of my will. And here we go, phase 3. Full health again. I've only got 20 potions left. I would like more. Oh, my. I forgot about this part. Okay, all right. We're gonna stand. Nope, not gonna stand in there. Camera, get out of the way. Go home, Korvac, you're drunk. Oh my god, yeah. Like, this game, Grim Dawn doesn't escape that though, with like all the particle effects where you can't see what's going on, but yeah, Path of Exile is just as bad. The only difference is that, like, Path of Exile, if you miss something, you die, whereas in this, I mean, I guess if you're on ultimate, you'll get gibbed if you're not being careful. But for the most part, you have, like, a chance to react to things. Whereas, like, Path of Exile, they balance around people playing with, like, logout macros and stuff. And it's just like, oh my god. And then they go on about, we want to slow the game down, but, like, they're only slowing players down. Monsters are still hyper lethal. It's just like, come on, guys. I don't know. I'm still going to play Path of Exile 2 when it eventually comes out. But I don't know if it's going to be a game that I'm going to dump, like, hundreds and hundreds of hours into ever again. Which is a shame, but yeah, it is what it is. I enjoyed the time I put into it. Like, I know a lot of people, like, they like the zoom-zoom gameplay of Path of Exile, but, like, this is about, like, this is, like, my happy place. If Path of Exile played like this, I would be playing it all the time. Like, I like boss fights where I actually have a chance to react to mechanics and stuff instead of, like, oh, I misstepped and I'm immediately dead, basically. And that's, sadly, the direction that Path of Exile went. Like, I fought two of the new bosses that they added with this league, and, like, the first one, I managed to just, by the skin of my ass, managed to kill because I had enough DPS to put it down before it killed me on my last portal. It had mechanics to the fight, but I'll be fucked if I actually know what they are, because as soon as it started attacking me, if I wasn't doing the mechanic, I had, like, 2 seconds to live. And it's like, really? How the fuck are people supposed to learn these fights? Give me Fisher-Price mode. Give me, like, a practice mode. That would be another thing that they could do to make stuff more accessible for Path of Exile, is just give me a practice mode for the fights. Like, let me go in and fight whatever boss I want. Like, don't give me any rewards or anything, fuck it. Like, even take my experience if I die. Like, just let me keep doing the fight so I can figure out how to actually do the fight without having to waste, you know, hours and hours and hours of my time to get to the fight. Whoa, I'm dead, I'm not dead. Esports. Oh. I don't know how I didn't die there. I was at like 50 hit points. Skill's not ready. I don't even know what happened. Like, I was fine until I wasn't. It's actually got some good music to it. Digging it. This guy needs to die, though. Freaking gods, man. Why can't they just go down? Two more portals than you might have won. I've done, like, the basic bitch mode elder fight and succeeded on it once in probably 2,500 hours of playtime. And certainly never on one of my own builds. I basically, anymore, I only play, like, whatever build I can find on the forums that looks fun. It's just like, oh my god.
That skill's not ready.
Almost out of healing potions. I've only got two left. I need to disengage long enough for my constitution to heal me. There it goes. Okay, we're good. Oh my god, guy. Just stay on the ground and let me kill you. Yeah, that's basically how I am as well. I have, in all of my time playing Path of Exile, I had one build that I could take to endgame of my own. It was a Cyclone Marauder. I can't remember what he was. I think maybe a Chieftain? But that was like right after Lab came out, so all the ascendancies were pretty nutso. It was pretty good, but yeah, since then, not so much. I think the most fun I've ever had on any character was an Arc Miner, though. Like, it was just pure easy mode. And I've got a Berserker Ground Slam, which is what I was playing on Standard recently, and that was pretty good. He's held up okay. He's not chunky enough to do end game, but he's fun enough. Back into your cage! Yeah, balance, but loot first. I think I used Kondo's Pride on my Cyclone. Oh yeah, the Arc Miners when I played them were the exact same. Like, you hit the button and just everything dies. I think I played, that character was in Delve, and like, I spent so much time in Delve. I absolutely love Delve. I wish they'd add it as like an alternative to playing the campaign. Just love trolling around in those mines. But yeah, to my understanding, Arc Miners have been nerfed into like Oblivion, sadly. Alright.
See anything you like?
Buy my crap. Didn't even ding off of that. Although I guess we leveled before we went in, so. Hey, buddy.
Korvac's anguished cries have echoed across realities.
An endless Delve for a week. Oh, man. I'm sad that I missed that. I would have probably loved that. I love Delve so much. It's just a shame that you have to, like, build a character that's, like, fairly specific to be able to survive once you get pretty deep in. Korvac is no more.
His cult has been crushed. Even now, his scattered followers are being hunted down and eliminated. The Forgotten God will soon be a distant memory. Without a vessel, his powers will wane, and he shall fade into nothingness. Never again will the people of Cairn have to fear for their lives at the mercy of Korvac's fickle temper and destructive malevolence. Know that the Witch Gods are grateful for your sacrifice, even if they do not thank you in person. Wherever your journey leads next, their eyes will be upon you. Here, a prize from the gods themselves.
Thanks, bro. What will the cults do now?
We must ensure that none of Korvac's followers survive what happened here. If belief in Korvac persists, then a spark of his being shall remain. We must snuff it out while we can.
But you said he'll never again be a threat.
Korvac will never again be a threat of the magnitude we faced this day. That I promise you. Without a vessel to contain his primordial form, his powers will wane. And should he ever hope to return to Cairn, the Witch Gods will see to his demise. But if he is truly forgotten...
Korvac said the Elder Trome was his. Why?
Do not think to believe the snake tongue of that being. It spreads naught but lies. The Eldritch Realm is the domain of the three. Now and forever.
I love this, just like, alright. And that is the end. Alright, so we do have the Mother's Gift. Deliver the pendant to someone it was important to. Do I actually know who that is? Mother's Gift. Bears no name, appears to be of a mother figure, possibly a mother to someone with a Rubaruk family. Okay. I think that's probably in the base game, if I had to guess, so we're not gonna be able to do that yet. We'll have to wait. We got a Celestial Lotus, which is a fucking rare crafting ingredient. And a Wraith Blade, or a Wrath Blade. Which looks nifty, but which I will not use. Our fucking two healing potions. Jesus. Alright. I actually think, on that note, I'm going to go ahead and call it a stream here. A little bit early, but we finished the game. So, I think, yeah. is as good a place as any.